A short essay on Rebel Without a Cause. To coldly address the themes and dissect the moving parts is the best approach to such a supernova of reality and experience. I'll focus on three relationships. 1. Jim's relationship with his father. 2. Jim in contrast to Plato. 3. Judy in love with Jim. The draw for me to this film, aside from its mimetic notoriety and iconic aesthetic, was the idea of a revolution in dating in the modern era. To go back to a more quaint and humble time, before landline and automobiles were so common, dating revolved around the family, family homes, family meals, family connections. Dating was local and slow. But in Rebel Without a Cause, 1955, we truly see the radical new nature of dating in full swing. Families remain at home while boisterous youths speed into danger and towards each other in a cavalcade of energy and testosterone, even to the point of death. Now, the plot revolves around Jim, the protagonist, played by James Dean. Jim is a young man of good character. He strives against fear and cowardice in pursuit of upholding his honour. And this is the key battle in his adventure, his will to fight. Jim's father is a beaten down, hollowed out vessel of a man who has lost touch with manly virtue. He's seen on his knees in a frilly apron or fumbling and failing to provide his son with any helpful fatherly advice or support. He is weakness personified, although by the end of the film, he creates a semblance of redemption for himself, standing up with his son and vowing he will strive for the strength his son wants to see in him. The weakness of Jim's father, I believe, provides Jim with the exact example of what he wants to avoid for himself. He sees the small capitulations and moral failings that led his father to such a pathetic state, and this explains his willingness, despite fear and despite danger, to act boldly and face the danger courageously. He looks never to fall to weakness and desperately fights to embolden his father as well, actually succeeding in the end. Plato is a friend of Jim's, who reveals himself to be an opposite of Jim. Not in their struggles, as I see many similarities between the natures of these two characters. Namely, they both seem a little bit autistic. The difference isn't in the level of the challenges they face, but in how they face them. Plato, fearful, erratic, and dependent, as a result, meets an unstoppable fall. On the same timeline, we see Jim rise as a victor, a lover, a friend, and an inspiration, even to his own father. Now I'll explain Judy and Buzz. Buzz is a great antagonist. He lives for the conflict and danger. A good enemy and a good sport. In his war against Jim, an unwelcome male he seeks to destroy. He becomes friends with his enemy before meeting his end. And his enemy, Jim, goes on swiftly and easily to take his girlfriend, a day after taking his life. Or maybe through his recklessness he lost these things all by himself. Whatever the case, this is how the scenes unfold, and Judy falls in love with Jim and seems to bear no regard to the loss of her boyfriend. No grief, no mourning, no time to wait. Almost instantly she wants Jim now. This should be no surprise to those familiar with the concept of collaboration horizontale or the psychological phenomenon of war brides. But seeing this girl instantly taking the hand of the man who killed her lover, then quickly going on to vie for his attention and chase him round like a puppy dog, is quite the thing to behold. For the experiences of these complex relationships alone, this film is a masterpiece.